welcome to this session of Mindfulness, Awareness, and Compassion Practice. We'll do a series of short practices, which then you can take on your own and expand as you as works for you in your own practice outside of the session. And you can also come back to the session on YouTube and practice along if you'd like to do that. We'll start with setting up our posture and a grounding, settling, centering practice. Then we'll go to mindfulness of our present experience, then expand that into awareness of the larger environment. And finally, a practice that we can use to extend compassion and think of others more than we think of ourselves. Something that I've been working with my students lately has come up, and it pervades everything, both my golf coaching, other sports, and any kind of performance coaching, and then extending out into life. And that is concern for outcomes. How are things going to turn out? We spend so much of our time rehearsing, pre-playing in our imagination. Well, they're going to say this, then I'll say that, and then they'll say this, then I'll say that, and then I'll get it to where I want. And sometimes we, after a situation, if it doesn't turn out the way we expected, we go back and replay it. Well, if I had only said this, then they would have said that, and then I could have said this, and then it would have worked out the way I wanted. And it's all about concern for things working out the way we want them to. It turns out that concern, that concern is really about things turning out the way we feel that we need them to. And if we have unconditional confidence on ourselves, then we don't need things to turn out any particular way. We can handle whatever comes across. That doesn't mean we don't want, or we wouldn't like things to turn out a particular way. That's a positive vision. And that's what people ask, you know, when you say visualize what you want to happen, isn't that thinking about the future? Well, that's a positive intention. But if you have attachment to that, and if it doesn't turn out that way, you'll be devastated. Then there's going to be all sorts of interference. So the key phrase is see what happens. We make our plan, we do our best preparation, and then we execute and see what happens. And that's, again, in everything that we do. So in applying this to this particular practice, people sometimes get frustrated and say, well, I can't meditate. My mind won't stay still. The idea is not necessarily to still your mind. It's to work with your mind and discover and understand it. And in the process, pacify the unnecessary upheavals. If we go into the practice saying, I need it to come out this way, I need it to feel good, then we're setting up a tension that doesn't work. And as one of my golf students, Christy Kerr, who was number one in the world on the LPGA tour, she came up with this great acronym when we worked on this, and that is WAR, worry about results. When we worry about results, we're at war with ourselves. And you can actually feel it in your body. If there's a contraction, a protection, a tightening, that comes from worrying about results. And it's an old deep brain function of survival that actually is counterproductive in most of our current situations. You know, in the terrible places where there's war in the world, it's appropriate because it is about survival. But for most of us, and you know, if you're on the golf course or in a meeting with somebody, it's not so much about survival, although our brain thinks it is. So that's what we're working with. So as you practice, have a sense of humor. If your mind wanders, mind tends to wander. We're going to smile. Make a mental note if you'd like, which is thinking or thought. And that's shorthand for I was lost in thoughts and now I'm back. And the practice itself throughout this is returning to what we were doing. And that's a traditional definition of that's translated as mindfulness. It's an ancient Indian word, sati. And it basically says remembering what you're doing. As soon as the daydream pops, we're already back. At that moment, remember what you were doing and return to that with a sense of humor about the fact that you wandered. And if your intention is to be present more and more and more, your mind, body, system, your being, we'll move in that direction if you don't give yourself a hard time about it. So let's get started. For the start of the practice, we'll close our eyes and get settled in. But then a lot of the practice is with our eyes open because we're taking this not just to sit, but to put into our everyday lives. When that happens, it's best not to be looking directly into the screen, but turn somewhat sideways or move your device to the side. So let's take our posture. And it's basically sitting up to pay attention to what we're experiencing. Like when we were in school, the teacher said, sit up and pay attention. So we sit up. And that's upright, but not rigid. We talk about a firm back and a soft or open front. So feel like there's it'll feel like a straight line from the top of the back of your head all the way down to your tailbone. Our actual spine and neck have natural curves to them, but it'll feel like a straight line. Feel your sit bones pressing evenly into the chair or cushion that you're on. If you're on if you're on a cushion, you sit cross-legged. If you're in a chair, you can have your feet flat on the floor directly below your knees, about hip width apart. But if your legs are long or your chair is low and your knees are higher than your hips, it's better to have your knees lower than your hips. So you can gently cross your legs right there at the ankles, a little further if you need to, so that your knees are slightly below your hips. Let your arms hang straight down from your shoulders. So your upper arms are just hanging straight down. Then leave your elbows where they are and swivel your hands so they're palm down on each thigh, respectively. This is a part that's helpful to have a more open front. I'll show you. Our sternum goes from a notch near our throat to a notch at the bottom of our rib cage in the front. And a little ways up, about four finger widths up from the bottom, there's a little tender spot. That represents our heart center. What I'd like you to do is feel like that lower part of your sternum your breastbone, move slightly forward and slightly up. Just a tiny bit. Quarter of an inch, half an inch. Don't force anything. Just slightly up. You feel that your chest opens across. Your shoulders come back naturally. If you keep that straight line up to the back of your head, your chin comes in naturally. And your breathing should be more open when that happens. It might feel more open when that happens, which is good. Makes it easier for a full breath to come in. Let your jaw be soft, but not hanging open, so that your lips are just slightly parted or just barely touching. Now tune into that posture. Feel your feet, calves, thighs, sit bones, pelvis, whole lower part of your body. Feel your torso as it fills and empties, as the breath comes in and out naturally. Be an observer of the breath rather than a controller. Just let your body breathe as it will. But feel the depth front to back of your body. We're aware of the height and the width, but sometimes we think of ourselves the way we see ourselves in a mirror, two-dimensionally, just our front. We have depth front to back. That's what's filling as the breath goes in and out. Feel your shoulders, arms, forearms and hands, the whole torso and limbs, and how your neck balances your head on your shoulders. When you lift your sternum just slightly up and forward, you have a firm back but an open front, and it's a dignified, uplifted posture. Like a king or queen sitting on a throne. Within our posture, let's scan and remove residual tension that we're holding, that we may not even be aware of. So turn your awareness to your scalp, forehead, your eyes, cheeks, and jaw. We hold tension in our jaw we're not aware of sometimes. Just let it soften without your mouth opening. Neck and shoulders. Sometimes we walk around with our shoulders near our ears and think that they're relaxed. Just really let them hang. Let the tension melt and flow down and out of you. Chest, upper back, stomach, lower back, and deep belly. Sometimes our deep belly and pelvic region are clenched. We don't realize it. We're tight. Without losing your posture, just let them all soften. go. Arms, your shoulders down to your elbows, your forearms, wrists, hands, and fingers. Just let the tension melt away and soften. Legs, your thighs, knees, calves, ankles, and feet. You have your upright posture, open heart, good head and shoulders. Everything else softened. Feel yourself sink, your sit bones sink into the seat that you're on. Sink down, feel it's as if you're merged with the earth, solid, stable, centered, but upright, like a mountain, majestic like a mountain. Let your breath come and go. Like a gentle breeze. Or like gentle waves coming up on the shore and going back in. And finally, relax. Let your mind relax. Let your awareness drop. Let your mind drop into your body. Part of our tension is being so much in our head. Drop down. Let your mind rest deep in your core. Down below your navel, just in front of your spine. Quiet down there. Body's connected to the earth like a mountain. The breath comes and goes like waves. The mind is quiet but open. Be open to see what happens. Open like the sky. Clouds pass by, birds, planes. The sky contains all of them, but is undisturbed by them. Body like a mountain, breath like waves, mind like the sky. As the gong fades, let your eyes gently open about halfway so that you're maintaining your posture, but looking down under your eyelids, just a few feet in front of you. Wherever your eyes rest, just soften your gaze so you're looking in that direction, but not at something in particular. It's as if your awareness rests on the space that your body is sitting in. and direct your attention to the deep core of your torso. The feeling of filling or expanding, emptying or contracting as the body breathes in and out. Rest your mind there, aware of the space that your body's sitting in, aware of your posture, mainly focused on that feeling of filling and emptying as the breath goes in and out. And again, if you wander off into a daydream, just smile when you realize it. You're already back. Just reconnect with your posture, the space you're sitting in, and the feeling of filling and emptying. We'll do that for a couple of minutes. If you've gotten sleepy, your eyes have closed, and you've slumped a bit, Just reinvigorate your posture. Raise your gaze a bit so you're looking further out. Be aware of the breath coming in and going out through your nostrils. If your mind has been really busy, you've hardly had awareness of your breath at all, it's okay. Just put your attention deep in your core and be aware of the more detailed texture of your experience. How it starts to fill, filling and full, tiny gap of transition, and then starting to empty, emptying and empty. Attention to the details of that experience, filling and emptying. We'll continue for a couple more minutes. As the gong fades, just move around a little bit. Take a fresh start. You know, reconnect with your posture. This time, let your eyes be open naturally. And from your good posture, open heart, firm back, your eyes have a direction that they rest in naturally. Slightly downward from horizontal, but not very low. So just look out naturally and soften your gaze. Open up your peripheral vision, side to side, top to bottom. Just open to the space that you're sitting in front and all around you. As your breath goes out, it naturally mixes with the air in the room, disperses and dissolves and becomes inseparable from the air in the room. In the same way, as you breathe out, let your mind open up to the space in the room or beyond, whatever space you're looking out at and sitting in. And in the same way as your breath mixes with the air in the room, let your mind just mix with the space. Open up, become one with the space, so that your awareness and the space are not separate. Breathe out, open, and rest in that spacious openness. The body breathes in by itself. It's included in your awareness, but you don't follow the breath in. Go out with the breath, open, rest in spaciousness. We'll do that for a couple of minutes. And as the gong fades, open even further. Reconnect with your posture. Look out at or above the horizon. Imagine you're looking out and your awareness extends out to the sky in all directions. Let go of your limits and imagine your awareness extends out beyond the sky, out into space. Beyond all limits, beyond the farthest star, infinitely open. Rest for a moment in that open spaciousness. That spaciousness dissolves any notion of here or there. It's simply open space, open mind. And that open mind is the basis of our working with others. When we really open our hearts, we touch our natural compassion, our natural caring. And to begin the practice, imagine someone very close to you, a loved one. You can have your eyes open or closed, but imagine them in front of you. You know what makes them happy. You know what makes them suffer. And imagine that you could take away their suffering. As you breathe in, you can gather all their suffering into your open heart of compassion. And hold it. And how good it feels to free them from that. And extend that good feeling back out to them. The feeling of being able to relax, to let go, to be free of worry. To be free of whatever pain they're going through. Imagine that you could take that from them and send them instead kindness, caring, peace, health, and contentment. Next, explore your own being. How hard a time we give ourselves. Feel the tension, the struggle, any negative feelings about yourself. Open your heart. And as you breathe in, gather all those negative feelings into your own heart of compassion. And as you breathe out, let your heart radiate and fill your being with soothing kindness, soothing any pain, soothing any struggle. Your open heart of compassion is like an air purifier, Breathe in the heavy smokiness of suffering. Breathe out the cool, clean air. Kindness, contentment, and peace. Expand that to all your loved ones, all family and friends. Notice how there's no limit to your capacity to gather in all their suffering into that vast open heart of compassion we all possess. And purify the energy to send out. As you breathe out, imagine that you're radiating out cool moonlight of kindness that fills all their beings with peace, health, and contentment. Breathe in to gather the suffering. Breathe out relief. And recognize that all people everywhere, all living beings, suffer and struggle and want peace and contentment. So expand as best you can to ever wider circles of people, animals, all living beings. It may come to mind that there are beings who seem to not want peace, but want to wage war. From individuals to nations. But that's a manifestation of fear, ignorance, hatred, jealousy, greed. All negative emotions. Beneath those emotions, all beings want peace, health, and happiness for themselves and their loved ones. But the confusion of these negative emotions make people mad. Mad in anger and mad in craziness. So extend your caring to want to take in and take away from everyone, free them from all those negative, painful emotions that cause them to harm themselves and others. Breathe in to your open heart of compassion all these negative emotions. Purify and send out the opposite. Caring, kindness, love, understanding, patience, acceptance, wisdom. Take in ignorance, hatred, and fear. Send out wisdom, acceptance, and love. And that way we purify the world of the pollution of all these negative emotions. Confusion, ignorance, and misunderstandings. Replace it with wisdom and compassion. That every being has the capacity for. And as the gong fades, let go of what you're imagining. Reconnect with your posture. Lower your gaze and just be aware of your body sitting in the space in the here and now. That concludes our meditations. And to further our intention, our compassion, we can share an expression of wanting to benefit others. And you can repeat after me or put it in your own words. May the practice we have just done be of benefit to others as well as ourselves. And if you're feeling particularly generous or want to cultivate that generosity, you can say something like, may the practice I've just done be of even more benefit to others than to myself. So thank you very much, and that concludes our session. Thank you.